Good evening and welcome to Newswatch at 6. I'm Rebecca Fernandez. Starting off tonight, Jaeger Airport has reopened today after the deadly plane crash that occurred on Friday morning. Eyewitness News reporter Bob Aaron is at Jaeger Airport to explain what crews had to do to get everything running again.
There was some heavy lifting to do before Jaeger could get back into safe operations. The National Transportation Safety Board returned control of the runway to the airport early this morning. Crews quickly patched the damage from the violent impact of the air cargo carrier's plane with the runway and swept away small pieces of the aircraft crash that killed two people. But removing the wing close to the runway seemed too much for the small crane tasked with the job. Eventually, they backed a trailer under the swinging wing and loaded it. The airport shutdown brought on by runway damage and the crash investigation was highly unusual. The skies over Charleston hadn't been this quiet since 9/11. Frustrated passengers dealt with a second day of the shutdown.
I was told yesterday, but then I was told that the problem was resolved and the airport was still open, but it doesn't look like it.
An older couple wondered if they'd make their cruise ship trip out of New Orleans.
They won't wait for one out of 3,000. Or two out of 3,000.
But by 12:28 p.m., the wing had been towed across the airport into an Air National Guard hangar. A C-130 fired up its engine and took off. A passenger jet followed. Down the hill, the water company checked airport runoff for fuel spilled in the crash. And further up the hill, the NTSB probe into the deadly accident continued. Normal operations have resumed on an abnormal day.